Hello, today we will see how to prepare a flowchart for writing a computer code for plane stress having n number of nodes and m number of elements. So let's get started. Okay, so here is one problem, general problem we are considering, that is truss problem. So in this there will be a n number of nodes and m number of elements. So there are basically three types of methods we can use to solve this problem. First one is the analytical method. Second one is to create a computer code to solve this problem. And third one is directly ANSYS. So analysis we can do in this ANSYS and we will get the results. So today we will see about computer coding, how to prepare a flowchart. In this, you don't need to write a computer code, only you have to prepare a flowchart for this. So let's see the general procedure for this truss element. First of all, we need a material data. So material data means, so these are the elements having Young's modulus, then cross section area, Poisson's ratio. That data we need initially. After that we have to prepare a node numbers and elements. According to our problem we will give the node numbers and then we will give the element numbers and connectivity between these two elements, means we will prepare an element connectivity table. Then we have to prepare a element stiffness matrix. For this, all m number of elements, then according to that node numbering we have to prepare a global stiffness matrix, means we have to assemble all these stiffness matrices into this global stiffness matrix. Now if this problem is having n number of nodes, so size of this stiffness, global stiffness matrix, will be n number of nodes into degrees of freedom, means it will be the size of global stiffness matrix, n into degrees of freedom into n into DOF. Okay, then after getting this global stiffness matrix, we have to prepare this system equation, that is F is equal to KX. Then apply the boundary conditions, means here are the fixed support, roller support, that boundary conditions we have to apply. And then we will get this reduced stiffness equation. So that is F is equal to K into X, where F is a force applied on these nodes, X is the displacement, K is the global stiffness matrix. So after getting this reduced system equations, we have to use proper method to solve this problem. And then we have to calculate the results. Means after solving this stiffness equation, we will get displacement, and from that displacement we have to calculate stress, strain, reactions, and it's done, means you will get the all result. So this is the general procedure. Now we will see how to create a computer code flowchart. For this we use MATLAB or C++ languages for doing this computer code. So we have to prepare a flowchart. So here it is. Now this is the flowchart over here. Initially we have to start, then read the input data, means what is the material data we have, that we have to take as a input data over here, means you have to take Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio. It is collected from the user end. Then localization. Localization means what? We have to prepare element and node connectivity. After that we have to prepare a stiffness matrix. After localization we will get area value, E value and mu value. From that we can prepare this stiffness element stiffness matrix. Then but here we have to allocate element stiffness matrix, global stiffness matrix, force matrix and U matrix array. Means initially computer doesn't know the size of these matrices, so we have to prepare a zero matrix having the size of this K matrix. Means according to our problem we will understood what is the size of this K matrix. For example, it is 2 by 2, then we have to prepare a 2 by 2 zero K matrix. If it is global stiffness matrix, then we have to prepare a global K matrix of all zeros having n into degrees of freedom, that is the range of this K matrix. Similarly, force column vector, then U column vector of all zeros. Then we will go for the computing the stiffness matrices. So here we will do the calculations for getting the small k. We will get the one small k for first element, then we will go for a second step, assembly. Use the direct method to add k, that is element stiffness matrix, to correct location in the global stiffness. Means in this global stiffness where this k is localized, we have to put that values in this global stiffness matrix. Then after we have solved for first element, when it comes to here, is there any more elements? Yes, because only one element we have considered up to here, then it is yes. Again we will go back to the computing the stiffness, element stiffness. Then we will prepare the element stiffness matrix for second element, then we will assemble into position of this global stiffness matrix. Then again the question, if yes, it will goes to this position step again. So this process continues until there is a last element. When we get the element stiffness matrix for last element, then we will add it into a global stiffness. Then it comes to here, the answer is no, because there is no more elements. Now then we have to apply the force. Initially we have defined this zero force vector. Now we have to put the values over here in the force vector. Then apply the force vector and we will get a system equation, that is F is equal to Kx. So this system equation we have to prepare over here. After that, next position step is apply constraints. Means we have to apply the fixed support and roller support. In the coding language, we have to define the zero values for the displacement and apply it into this equation and get a reduced system equation in this step. In the next step, we have to solve F is equal to Ku. Means here we have to solve this equation. We can use any method, inverse method or Gauss elimination method, to solve this problem over here. We have to prepare code for that. After getting a result, we will get only displacement. Then what we have to do? Then we have to calculate the results. Means internal forces, stress, strains and reaction. That we will calculate after getting this U value. And the last one is to write the results. Means we will write the results as per the nodes, as per the elements in the table format. And it will complete your computer code. So this is the general flowchart to solve the truss problem. Thank you.